Today in the news, we got some super fast SSDs, some DDR4, and some living portrait. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. I told you, I called it. Although it's not like anyone was opposing me on this. Ever since the PS5 claims came out from their lead architect, one thing they've been raving about is their SSDs. Mark Cerny from PlayStation said that it had a raw bandwidth faster than anything seen on PCs right now. I did point out that right now, in May of 2019, that claim made sense, since all we have right now are M.2 NVMEs that are pretty much capped out at 3.5 gigabytes per second because of PCIe 3.0's limitations. Well, that's about to change. Gigabyte just teased their world's first PCIe Gen 4 M.2 SSD, and it's fast. That little piece of storage will net you speeds of 5,000 megabytes per second. 5 gigabytes in reads and writes. Gigabyte also claims that it will do so with low temperatures, although I have a feeling that this is because the chipset or the CPU controller will be doing most of the heavy lifting. In the next year or so, I have no doubt that speeds of M.2 drives will reach as high as 7 gigabytes per second, since the technical limitation for 4-lane of PCIe Gen 4 is around 8 gigabytes per second. Anyways, this brings up another point. The only company that will be compatible with these sticks is AMD. Their Zen 2 architecture is the only one capable of running PCIe Gen 4 unless Intel decides to move up in the ladder. I guess we'll see about that at Computex. Speaking of AMD, the specs for their DDR4 memory support have just been leaked. The Zen architecture has been offering faster and faster stock memory support with 2666 DDR4 speeds with Zen, 2933 MHz with Zen Plus, and now Zen 2 will support 3200 MHz out of the box. So what does this mean? Well, speed of memory can be hit and miss. If you buy a 3200 MHz kit for a Ryzen 1000 or 2000 series of CPUs, it doesn't mean it will work. There is a bit of silicon lottery at play here. With base memory support bumped up to 3200 MHz, you can be sure that your Zen 2 CPU will support that 3200 MHz kit you just bought. On the leak, we can also see overclocked speeds of up to 4400 MHz plus, which is in line with what we've talked about last week when Yuri Bubbly found out that the upper limit of memory speeds would be 5000 MHz with Zen 2. Moving on in AI news, Samsung has been developing their own living portrait, aka Deepfake system, and it looks like it is a lot better than the traditional AI. To create a solid deepfake, you usually need a lot of images to create a realistic look. SCIP tested this at 500, 2000, and 5000 images to see how many were needed, and the results were showing that around 500 images were enough to create a solid deepfake. Samsung's AI, though, seems to be able to do that with just a single photo. Of course, you can add more to create a better living portrait, for example 8 or 32 as shown in this video, but it's clearly far off from the 500 needed for a deepfake. What is really interesting is the possibility to create a living portrait with angles that the AI never actually saw, like in this example. It's a little unclear how much computational power or how long these take to render, but it sure looks like it's going to be everywhere in a few years. In gaming, a sequel that I thought was dead is actually just in development hell. Dead Island 2 was announced back at the start of the current gen of consoles, and THQ Nordic just confirmed that it is still being worked on, alongside 80 other unannounced games. The trailer for the game is now 5 years old now, and the hype for it has pretty much ground to a halt. I thought Dead Island was a great game, and the second one would have been a nice sequel back in 2015, but now that we're in 2019, I don't know if a game like that still has its place. What do you guys think? Lastly, it looks like Overwatch will finally have a replay system. This was a feature that has been requested for a long time, and I'm glad to see it happen. With it, you can analyze your gameplay with extreme precision, thanks to speed modulation, multiple cameras, different types of views, and you even get a mini-map like on the Overwatch League. This feature is currently in testing in the PTR right now if you want to go and try it out. Personally, I have not played a regular game of Overwatch since the workshop hit the PTR. I've been playing the 2D custom mode that kind of feels like Super Smash Brothers, and I've been playing the Frogger type game mode where you avoid the cars to get to the tunnel. Anyways, guys, that is pretty much it for the news today. Hopefully you've enjoyed. If you got any questions, the comment section is there for you. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Stay frosty, my dudes, and I'll see you on the next one. I missed a tap on the table. I'm sorry.